Let us build a house where love can dwell and all can safely live. A place where saints and children tell how hearts learn to forgive. Built of hopes and dreams and visions, rock of faith and vault of grace. Here the love of Christ shall end divisions. All are welcome, all are welcome, all are welcome in this place. Let us build a house where prophets speak and words are strong and true, where all God's children dare to seek to dream God's reign anew. Here the cross shall stand as witness and as symbol of God's grace. Here as one we claim the faith of Jesus. All are welcome, all are welcome, all are welcome in this place.
All that you have done to us, O Lord, you have done with true judgment, for we have sinned against you and not obeyed your commandments, but give glory to your name and deal with us according to the bounty of your mercy. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
With your spirit.
Well, good morning again, and welcome to this celebration. It's the Lord's Day. It's the day that the Lord has made, the day of resurrection. It's the day that we come always to this sacred space to encounter the Lord in the most real way, certainly in his word proclaimed, which leads us then and prepares us for the table of his suffering and death, his Eucharist that he gives us. And where two or three are gathered in his name, he is present there as well. He's present in each and every one of us, a presence we carry with us when we leave the doors of this holy place. And so let us now greet one another and welcome the Christ into our midst.
Good to see you again.
Brothers and sisters, discipleship calls us to make radical choices about how we live as followers of Jesus. We ask God's pardon for the times that we have failed and for the strength to be his faithful disciples. Lord Jesus, you are the divine teacher. Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
Christ Jesus, you are the way to eternal life. Christe eleison.
Christe eleison.
Lord Jesus, you call disciples to act in your name. Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Amen.
Glory to God in the highest. people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world. Receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill.
Let us pray. O God, who manifest your almighty power above all by pardoning and showing mercy, bestow, we pray, your grace abundantly upon us, and make those hastening to attain your promises heirs to the treasures of heaven. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of Numbers. The Lord came down in the cloud and spoke to Moses. Taking some of the spirit that was on Moses, the Lord bestowed it on the 70 elders. And as the spirit came down to rest on them, they prophesied. Now two men, one named Eldad and the other Medad, were not in the gathering, but had been left in the camp. They too had been on the list, but had not gone out to the tent. Yet the Spirit came to rest on them also. And they prophesied in the camp. So when a young man quickly told Moses, Eldad and Medad are prophesying in the camp, Joshua, son of Nun, who from his youth had been Moses' aide, said, Moses, my Lord, stop them. But Moses answered him, are you jealous for my sake? Would that all the people of the Lord were prophets. Would that the Lord might bestow his spirit on them all.
The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The precepts of the Lord give joy to the heart. The precepts of the Lord give joy to the heart. The law of the Lord is perfect, refreshing the soul. The decree of the Lord is trustworthy, giving wisdom to the simple. The precepts of the Lord give joy to the heart. The fear of the Lord is pure, enduring forever. The ordinances of the Lord are true, all of them just. The precepts of the Lord give joy to the heart. Though your servant is careful of them, very diligent in keeping them, yet who can detect failings? Cleanse me from my unknown faults. The precepts of the Lord give joy to the heart. From wanton sin especially restrain your servant. Let it not rule over me. Then shall I be blameless and innocent of serious sin. The precepts of the Lord give joy to the heart.
A reading from the letter of St. James. Come now, you rich, weep and wail over your impending miseries. Your wealth has rotted away. Your clothes have become moth-eaten. Your gold and silver have corroded, and that corrosion will be a testimony against you. It will devour your flesh like a fire. You have stored up treasure for the last days. Behold, the wages you withheld from the workers who harvested your fields are crying aloud. And the cries of the harvesters have reached the ears of the Lord of hosts. You have lived on earth in luxury and pleasure. You have fattened your hearts for the day of slaughter. You have condemned. You have murdered the righteous one. He offers you no resistance.
The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Your word, O Lord, is truth. Consecrate us in the truth. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. At that time, John said to Jesus, "Teacher, we saw someone driving out demons in your name, and we tried to prevent him because he does not follow us." Jesus replied, "Do not prevent him. There is no one who performs a mighty deed in my name who can at the same time speak ill of me. For whoever is not against us is for us. Anyone who gives you a cup of water to drink because you belong to Christ, amen, I say to you, will surely not lose his reward. Whoever causes one of these little ones who believe in me to sin, it would be better for him if a great millstone were put around his neck and he were thrown into the sea. If your hand causes you to sin, cut it off. It is better for you to enter into life maimed than with two hands to go into Gehenna, into the unquenchable fire. And if your foot causes you to sin, cut it off. It is better for you to enter into life crippled than with two feet to be thrown into Gehenna. And if your eye causes you to sin, pluck it out. Better for you to enter into the kingdom of God with one eye than with two eyes to be thrown into Gehenna, where their worm does not die, and the fire is not quenched." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Expect the unexpected. In both the first reading and the gospel, we heard about some men who were prophesying in God's name that weren't part of the establishment. And in both cases, the wisdom of Moses and Jesus came through as they told their key followers to allow these men to continue to preach. Moses told Joshua, "All the people of the Lord should be prophets." Jesus told John the man was performing a mighty deed in his name. There's no doubt that both Moses and Jesus would tell you and me the same thing today, that both the expected and unexpected should proclaim the good news of the gospel to the world. The expected. Pope Francis's visit to America has been a big news topic this week and has generated a lot of excitement. While it makes sense that we Catholics would be interested in what the Pope is doing and what he has to say, I find it interesting that our largely secularized society is also listening closely. Pope Francis is expected to lead the charge in modern-day prophecy, and he is not disappointing us on this trip. The Pope was equally compelling whether he was presiding at the Mass where Blessed Junipero Serra became a saint, whether he was challenging the U.S. Congress to dispel the division that exists between our political parties and work for unity, or whether he was urging the United Nations to put aside individual country interests to seek the common good of all. But there's another side of Pope Francis that I think makes his prophecy speak even greater. Instead of dinner with Congress, he opted for dinner with the homeless in Washington, D.C. Instead of hanging out with the rich and famous, he went to a school in East Harlem, New York City. And instead of taking a breather this morning after Sunday morning mass, the Pope is headed to a local prison in Philadelphia to interact with the incarcerated. One thing I can definitely say about Pope Francis is his message and actions in regards to serving the poor and the downtrodden are very much in sync. We should expect this from and admire this about the leader of the Catholic Church. The unexpected. In the first reading, we heard how Moses endorsed the idea that Eldad and Medad should prophesy even though they weren't at the tent. Moses had been carrying the weight of the Jewish people solely on his back up until this time. And as those people wandered around in the desert, they were constantly grumbling about their state of affairs. So as a result, Moses called out to God and asked for help in dealing with the people. God spoke out of a cloud and bestowed the Spirit on 70 elders, two of which were Eldad and Medad. Now Moses was thrilled that the Spirit came on all 70. He needed all the help he could get. And he was delighted that Eldad and Medad, even though they weren't at the tent, were included in that number. As I try to make sense of the array of unexpected prophets in today's world, I am personally more leery than Moses. There are a lot of people out there who are speaking seemingly as prophets for the Lord that I don't think pass the sniff test. A few weeks ago, I was watching a documentary on television evangelists. With all due respect, some of the messages they were sending seemed to land more in the camp of the second part of the gospel, where in effect Jesus is telling us, cut it out. Here are two examples. One preacher told his audience, God told him he needed to raise $65 million for a jet plane for his ministry, that they should dig deep into their wallets to help his cause. And another evangelist told a woman who had cancer to put her faith in God and donate to that evangelist's cause instead of seeking medical treatment, that God would reward her faith with a cure. And unfortunately, that woman passed away. So as you and I journey along our road of faith, we have to be wary of those who take liberties with prophesying in God's name. So just how do we recognize a reliable, unexpected prophet today? I think it's a combination of humility, service, a careful choice of words, and putting God's words into action. So today, I would like to introduce you to Katie Davis. Katie had just graduated from high school near Nashville, and she planned to take some time off before going to college. She searched the internet for opportunities and found an orphanage in Uganda that was looking for help. So she signed up as a short-term volunteer. Katie went there with the intention of staying up to a year, coming back to a normal life, and going on to school. But God had other plans. He called her to prophesy from the cloud, so to speak. So today, Katie lives in a four-bedroom concrete house in Jinha, Uganda, where she has adopted 13 children. In addition, she has started a nonprofit organization that feeds and educates 2,500 Ugandan youth. Now for her careful choice of words. Here's one quote from Katie. It's hard to serve and serve and serve and treat every sick person that comes in your gate and bandage every wound and feed every hungry person and still know that 10 minutes away someone just died because they couldn't get to the hospital or they didn't have enough food. And another quote about the possibility of getting married. If some crazy dude wants to move to Uganda and wants this many children, and God ordains that, then great. But I am happy and content where I am. Now, I don't think there's any doubt that Katie's method of prophecy is in the mold of Pope Francis and not those TV evangelists that I mentioned. And finally, the unexpected are expected. Now, we gathered here today might consider ourselves among the unexpected, but as I thought about it, I don't think that's true. So let's go back to that first reading where Moses said this. Would that all the people of the Lord be prophets? Would that the Lord might bestow his spirit on them all? My friends, the Lord has bestowed the Holy Spirit on each one of us through our baptism and confirmation. In addition, Jesus bestows himself on us and within us each time we receive him in the Holy Eucharist. And Jesus' mercy is bestowed on us every time we go to the sacrament of reconciliation. So what is this that up to? That we are not unexpected prophets at all. We are Catholic Christians called to prophesy just like the 70 elders in that first reading and just like the apostles and disciples who followed Jesus throughout his ministry. As we leave this Mass today, I challenge each one of us to find a way to be a modern-day prophet for Jesus and his church. It doesn't have to be fancy, and it doesn't have to be earth-shattering like Katie, but let's find one way we can reach out to a world that needs to see the face of Jesus in us. If we do this in a genuine way, get ready. We can expect to see the unexpected happen as people return to the church, encounter God in a dramatic way, and become the next wave of prophets for the Lord.
We now stand and profess our faith as we say together, I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, from the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. The Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. He rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. Baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. We pray now that we may be faithful followers of Jesus, the teacher, and our response is, Lord, give us strength. Lord, give us strength.
For our Holy Father, Pope Francis, and all gathered at the World Meeting of Families, may the fruits of their work strengthen all families in their love for Jesus, we pray.
Lord, give us strength.
for all government leaders and legislators. May they make policies that support and strengthen families. We pray.
Lord, give us strength.
For those burdened with physical and mental illness, may they find courage in God, through whom all things are possible. We pray.
Lord, give us strength.
For catechists, parents, and students of our parish, that they may be blessed in their new year of religious education and sacramental preparation, we pray.
Lord, give us strength.
For Samantha Huseman and Brian Clark, and for Barbara Genzel and Dion Lang, who are united in the sacrament of marriage, and for Taylor Steele, who was baptized, we pray, Lord, give us strength. For all the living and deceased members of Most Blessed Sacrament Parish, for intentions in our prayer books and on our prayer line, and for the intentions we hold in our hearts. We pray,
Lord, give us strength.
For Adeline Markovsky, who has gone before us marked with the sign of faith, and for all those who have died, in particular we pray for James Nofke, Daryl Dux, and Marcella Eichstad. May they be welcomed into God's heavenly kingdom. We pray,
Lord, give us strength.
Good and gracious God, you are merciful to the sinner and kind to those who follow your Son. Hear these our prayers, that we might one day enjoy with you eternal life. We ask this through that same Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. And by the streams of Babylon we sat and wept when we remembered Zion. By the streams of Babylon we sat and wept.
Precious Lord, take my hand, lead me on, let me stand. I am tired, I am weak, I am worn. Through the storm, through the night, lead me on to the light. Take my hand, precious Lord, lead me home. When my way grows drear, precious Lord, linger near. When my life is almost gone, hear my cry, hear my call. Hold my hand, lest I fall. Take my hand, precious Lord, lead me home. When the darkness appears and the night draws near and the day is past and gone, at the river I stand, guide my feet, hold my hand, take my hand, precious Lord, lead me home.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Grant us, O merciful God, that this our offering may find acceptance with you, and that through it the wellspring of all blessing may be laid open before us through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For out of compassion for the waywardness that is ours, he humbled himself and was born of the Virgin. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from unending death, and by rising from the dead, he gave us life eternal. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all the host and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. In the
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For in the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me.
the mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and David, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassionate, merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
At the Savior's command and form of divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
And the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Peace be with you. Peace be with you. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Have mercy on us. on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. Remember your word to your servant, O Lord, by which you have given me hope. This is my comfort when I am brought low. This is my comfort when I am brought low.
We are many parts, we are all one body, and the gifts we have, we are given to share. May the Spirit of love make us one indeed. One the love that we share, one our hope in despair, one the cross that we bear. God of all, we look to you. We would be your servants true. Let us be your love to all the world. We are men. many parts, we are all one body, and the gifts we have, we are given to share. May the Spirit of love make us one indeed, one the love that we share, one our hope in despair, one the cross that we bear. So my pain is pain for you, in your joy is my joy too. All is brought together in the Lord. We are many parts, we are all one body, and the gifts we have, we are given to share. May the Spirit of love make us one indeed, one the love that we share, one our hope in despair, one the cross that we bear. All you seekers, great and small, seek the greatest gift of all. If you love, then you will know the Lord. We are many parts, we are all one body, and the gifts we have, we are given to share. May the Spirit of love make us one indeed, one the love that we share, one our hope in despair, one the cross that we bear.
Please be seated. Pray to St. Michael. St. Michael the Archangel. Let us pray. May this heavenly mystery, O Lord, restore us in mind and body, that we may be co-heirs in glory with Christ, to whose suffering we are united whenever we proclaim his death, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Go and announce the gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Glory and praise to our God, who alone gives light to our days. Many are the blessings he bears to those who trust in his ways. We, the daughters and sons of him who built the valleys and plains, praise the wonders our God has done in every heart that sings. Glory and praise to our God, who alone gives light to our days. Many are the blessings he bears to those who trust in his ways. In his wisdom he strengthens us like gold that's tested in fire. Though the power of sin prevails, our God is there to save. Glory and praise to our God, who alone gives light to our days. Many are the blessings he bears to those who trust in his ways.